Watch this free clip from my masterclass to see how to test your VSLs in feed. This one is a supplement, but it works for everything.
Oh, being everything that everybody is broad, so general awareness and specific market sophistication. Can you do that? Absolutely. Do not ever tell yourself you can't resonate your message with both people, but you can, and you should resonate one message to each of those people. You want to have multiple Facebook ad controls, multiple verticals to create your exponential profitability. Now, if I don't have the organization that I just described right in front of me, then when I look at this, what am I seeing? What do you see when you look at this? This being denoted as the lead, not just the opening, the lead, L-E-D-E. What elements do you see here? What are the elements?
Deeper core, new cause,
curiosity. A lot. It's just, it's blind.
Deeper core, new cause, specificity, market sophistication. Your total T is under 750. Now, is 750 a good number? Bad number? Right. What do you think?
How you've told it, I think it's below average. Like average, a good number is like 1100 or something like that, you told us.
Yeah. So this is actually, for somebody my age, a good number.
Yeah.
So 1100, 1200, like that's where T levels typically peak when you're young. As we get older, andropause, stress, alcohol, lack of sleep, nicotine, too much weed, too much sitting, not enough of the right exercises, not eating the right diet, not eating the right foods at the right time. There's so many reasons why our T numbers can drop. And there's so many ways that we can elevate them without TRT. So when you see a 750 number, the reason why that is impactful is because it's a high average for older men. And it makes them feel like that high average is below average. And that's the point. Because men are taught to be content with where they're at. If they have a higher than normal T level for their age, doctors seem to think you're doing well. I see that as an opportunity to do way better. Because if you raise your levels from 750 to 800, you're going to feel different. Men who raise their testosterone 50 points will feel different. Now, I take Tonkat Ali, and I have done before and after tests on only taking Tonkat Ali. And I have risen my numbers over 200 points using Tonkat Ali for almost just over 2 months, around 2 months. So I went to all those hormonal specialists, right? I got all those different consultations, different ways of looking at things. The lady who said, if you have a 750, you have no business getting TRT. None. Why? Because it's common to get TRT at 750. And yet she told me way back, 750 was way, it was okay that you don't need TRT. Why? Why, Manny? What don't I want to do? What don't I want to have happen?
You don't want your natural testosterone to produce itself?
Yes. If I start on TRT, my pituitary gland is going to be less active. So if it's already less active, it'll harden, calcify. So now Manny can talk about how this small part of your brain also controls vision. It can affect your A1C. It can influence high A1C numbers, pituitarism. In other words, doesn't produce enough LH, luteinizing hormone. So if I go on TRT, I know that my pituitary gland is hardening because it's not working. All the work that it's supposed to do is being done by a chemical, and it's bypassing the pituitary gland and going straight to the testes, which makes the pituitary gland get weak, 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 and harden, harden, harden. Okay. So does that make a difference if I'm looking at this lead? So then we go over here. See this tiny part of your brain. Okay, same positioning. Okay, the maestro of your testosterone, basically the same thing. Now I'm bringing in triggering andropause, aka male menopause. So that element, which was on page 9 in his script, is now brought to the top to allow men to raise their hands, because when I organized this campaign, this funnel UX, which I really want to get into more about funnel UX, but before we can even really envision the whole thing, we have to understand what we're working with and why. And by the way, when I say it's your job as an offer owner or a copywriter to blueprint funnel UX, because you're seeing how all the UX testing is going to affect the bigger picture and what that bigger picture is, what your upsells are and why, and what maybe they should be and why, where you're off or where you're spot on. But you need to have an equilibrium to know what homeostasis means in your total funnel. Homeostasis meaning every part is working symbiotically and synergistically with every other part for a seamless machine. When every other part isn't working with every other part, what happens to the machine? The whole thing breaks down. So it's my awareness of what men are aware of, both from a new and late adopter perspective, that allows me to have confidence that this lead is not only a strong test to against my positioning, but my engagement levels. Because I'm engaging you in a different way. I'm not just getting your attention in a different way, which is a different ad. I'm engaging you in a different way, taking you on a different short-term UX. That makes sense in my broader UX, my broader funnel UX. So all of these front end, all of these positionings, all of these UX variables fit in with where the landing page is and the upsells, so that I can have multiple controls here, going here, feeding here. Right? That's what exponential is. That's what it means. And you can't, or you likely, more likely, won't do it if you are not aware, supremely aware, on paper, so that you can look at it at what your customers are aware of, so that you can meet their awarenesses in different ways, very deliberately. And then when you look at that data, you know what to do less or more of, because you're looking at it for that purpose. Okay, I haven't made any sales yet. My CTRs are insane. I'm letting this run. My engagement is insane. I'm going to let it run. Oh, and then it starts breaking through as Facebook acclimated the right eyes for the offer. Okay, but no, that's great. You're starting to scale. Now you need to break that up into lots of different pieces so that you can have multiple ads scaling in that positioning. Because you've determined that this gets people to raise their hands. Now I need to see all the different ways I can get them to raise their hands to this in slightly different ways, so that I'm getting more early and more late adopters in individual and collective campaigns. That's how I constantly think about every offer that I'm running or writing for. Because if I don't take this time in my 80% to organize how I'm categorizing my 80%, how I'm leveraging my 80%, what if I have my 80% over 3 days and I forgot what I did 2 days ago, the questions I asked 2 days ago? If I have that down and I have it organized, I know how to build on it. I know how to maybe replace it with something more effective as the 80% reveals new opportunities, new awarenesses about my audience that gives me awarenesses for how to connect with them in new or different ways, or slightly tweaked, or all of the above, to see which of them work or how many of them work more likely. But it's all very deliberate, all knowing exactly what I'm doing and why, what makes this test effective, what makes this test done before it ever really gets started. And because of my hyper awareness on those things, I'm able to very easily respond to data. Without any charge, I have no attachment to any copy. Whatever works, works. Whatever doesn't, doesn't. And I'm great with it. Because I have no confusion about the conversations I'm having, the three main points of positioning at the sophistication level, the three main points of positioning on a broad market awareness level, how I'm engaging people with my headlines and my primary copy, my thumbnail and the first line of my video copy, or the static headline in my static image, and what that static image is, to create enough variables to see what gets the most people to raise their hands, or different people to raise their hands for different ways of expressing the same positioning without even getting into different positioning. Because then, now, let's say I'm this tiny part of the brain. Now I want to hyper test andropause, male menopause, right at the top. How would that look? All right. So now I brought male menopause to the top. And what did I push down?
The pituitary gland.
And I made the pituitary gland secondary to my A2 positioning, which is male menopause. So now, instead of getting people's engagement through the pituitary, through the small part in the brain that produces the luteinizing hormones that creates testosterone, I am going to the reason why you are in massive testosterone decline and why nothing else has worked to get your desire, drive, and ability to perform for any length of time without blowing your wad just as you're getting in there.
Can I ask a question, please?
Yes.
Thank you. You've got 10 leaders that you're checking, and you're not invested in any of them in particular because you want the market to tell you the outcome. You don't go in, but your market research, and also that the thing, the Pareto effect, would tell you that 80% of your best performance will be out of 20%. So 2 out of the 10 are going to rank much higher than the other 8. Is that your experience? Have you found the Pareto effect? Because it seems to me to be quite a, 80% of your fundraising money comes from 20% of your donors, 80% of your problems in teams comes from 20% of the team members, the 80-20 rule. So you're finding that you've deliberately chosen 10 leaders because on the Pareto effect, two of them will be outstanding compared to the other ones. And that's where you know where to invest. Is that correct?
I hate when the cursor won't make the part that says that all the controls for Zoom to show up. Yes. So once I've done my 80% and I'm aware of what my prospects are likely aware of, I'm aware of the story they're likely telling about the problem I can help them solve, and understanding why they're either still trying to serve that, solve that, or why they just realized the problem and would prefer to go to the real solution addressing the deeper core than all those other solutions I see people using that just deal with the symptoms. Right? That is my awareness about their awareness. So when I'm throwing ads at their Bronwyn, I'm just kind of going, that's all it is. I'm just giving you opportunities to raise your hands. Manny.
Yeah.
Are you in the stock, Manny?
Yes.
Write an alternative lead in 1 minute that is an alternative to this, starting with male menopause, pushing down the pituitary gland. Go. I got a timer on. I'm lying.
Okay, I think I'm not able to edit the doc. Sorry.
You're just buying time. Come on.
Yeah.
Right. There you go.
Come back to you in 10 minutes, man.
All right, timer on. 1 minute. Now, why am I doing this?
Because you're a sadist?
What was that?
Because you're a sadist?
Do you know, Manny, let's see, Jonathan, Matt, how many times have you sat down and you're like, oh my God, I could write so many things, but I don't know what to write. I could do this, wait. Nope. Oh, shit, no.
Yeah.
Right? You can eliminate all of that by being aware of what your audience is aware of. So then you can tap into the essence and let it come through your fingertips, because you've done the 80%. You have no pressure on yourself because you know you can write this in a million different ways and get lots of different people to raise their hands to many of those different ways.